Hello, ladies and gentlemen, it's Critical, and welcome back to another episode of Comic Craft on the Comic Craft server. We're back over here at our base after a little hiatus last episode. We did some caving and took a little bit of a break from all of the work that I've been doing because I've been AFKing for like the last 2 weeks to get the copper that we need for this roof, and with a little bit of help from Sky and a couple of gifts from some other people as well, I was able to finally get this thing finished. And as you can see, it's looking pretty cool. I've changed some stuff up here from what we had before. So, of course, the roof is in place. I fell. I didn't mean to do that. The roof is in place, so we are good to go with that. But I've lowered down this floor. We were originally going to put this up here, and we had some stairs here. I've lowered this down a little bit to match closer to the real building that we're basing this off of. And I've added in these little divots here as well, just to add a little bit of detail there. And so now the roof is officially done. And these are slabs, so nothing will spawn up here, which is great. We don't have to worry about lighting this area up if we don't want to. I'll probably add some like spotlight sort of things on the edges just to get this thing to glow a bit. By the way, this looks really, really cool at night. I've added in some torches on top. You can see them here. I've added in some torches on top of these windows. So these actually glow, but of course, because it's tinted glass, they don't let light out. And so it looks really, really cool, and I'll have to show you guys later in the episode how that looks. But let's head inside, because I've also worked out a floor for the first floor here, and I want to show you guys this. I've been working on this over the last couple weeks as well, just on and off. I had to grab a ton of this, was this calcite? Is that what it's called? Yes, calcite. So I've done like a calcite diorite floor, which I think looks pretty cool. And as you can see, I've kind of tried to, I started over here and worked my way toward that corner over there. So we have like this nice streak pattern. It's kind of randomized throughout the room. You can see there's a lot of groupings of these. Now, of course, this won't be the whole floor down here, and there's going to be lots of areas that we wall off that are going to be other rooms and hallways and stuff. But as for the main area and the main sort of circular area we're going to have with a big staircase going up here, this is going to be the floor design for that area, which I'm pretty excited about. I think this looks really cool, and I think this is a good way to implement these two blocks. We are over here at the shopping district now, though, because I want to show you guys a couple of things that have been going on over here. It's about to be nighttime. That's not good for my health. There's a couple of new buildings that have popped up over here, which are really cool. I'm falling in water. There's a ramen store, I believe this is. Yeah, so there's like a little ramen cart here, which is... Uh-oh. Okay, I clicked this. I was like, what did I click? There's a little ramen cart here, which is pretty cool. It's got like wheels, and it's got like these really cool trapdoor overhangs and a little exhaust port up there, which is really creative and cool, but it's not the only one. That actually, I think, popped up second. I think Karkat's Cake Shop popped up over here first, which is also really, really cool. And check this out. This is awesome. So it seems that the kind of current running thing is that food is iron. As opposed to diamonds, like the rest of the shopping district charges, which is, I think, a pretty cool sort of separation between the two. I love this little building, though, because it's, like, dug into the mountain, and she's used vines on all of the, well, leaves on the back wall, but vines everywhere to kind of emphasize that a little bit as well, which I think is really cool. I don't have any iron on me, so I can't, wait, nope, I don't have anything on me because I just rearranged my chest, so I can't buy any, but that's very cool. Both of those are very neat, and I don't know if I've shown this on camera, but we also have Scruffy's rocket shop here, which is pretty cool as well. So gunpowder, TNT, and rockets. That being said, my copper farm that we built two episodes ago is producing ridiculous amounts of gunpowder, so I don't think I actually need to buy rockets from anyone anymore. I think I'm set on that. Let me make it daytime real quick, and then we'll talk about what we're actually doing here. Alright, so I'll be super quick about what I want to say here because I want to get started on what we're actually going to be building this episode, but basically, I want to build some more shops here, and of course, we got to go through, we got to work out like the paths and stuff here because everything's sort of spread out, so we have a lot of work to do here, but I want to build shops, and not just any shops, I want to build shops for other people. I don't particularly have an item or anything that I want to sell this season, so I thought what would be fun is if we constructed some sort of generically themed buildings, sort of like Blunber has over here, where you could sell any item or block you wanted to, because it's not, like, themed toward anything. It's sort of just, you know, anything could be sold here and you wouldn't question it. I want to build a bunch of buildings sort of like that, with different block palettes and stuff, that everyone can buy or rent from me, and all we'd have to do is you know, collect payment when needed. So I think that that's kind of our plan for the season. I don't know why I just pressed that. that was so dangerous. I saw a button, I was like, ooh, click. And that could have been hooked up to anything. I could have died. But yeah, so I want to put some shops over here. And basically, I want to spread them out a little bit. You know, I don't want to have, like, a complex or anything where I've built, like, a huge area that's all my buildings. I kind of just want to scatter them about and anyone can buy and sell them back to me, I suppose, as they need. If they find they don't have the need for a shop anymore, we can obviously break the contract at a, you know, at a high interest rate. And then that way we can make a little bit of profit and we don't have to worry about restocking any shops or anything like that, which I think will be pretty fun. But let's get back over to our base because I have a lot that I want to work on today and I'm pretty excited to get started. Well, we're back over at my base, but unfortunately it is pouring outside and I wanted to show you guys some stuff going on outside. I guess I don't have an umbrella on me. I guess we're just going to have to weather the storm, but this is not ideal. But check this out. So we have a little bit of a sidewalk that I've added up at the front. And as I've said, we're going to be doing a big road here. And we're not going to be doing this today because I need to gather a ton of deep slate for this road. I have the coolest road design that I think I've ever come up with for this road. And I'm very, very excited to show it to you guys. But what we're going to be doing is basically we're going to be dragging this down this way. And then it's going to go all the way to the back of the building over there and go up into the sky, as I said before. And then I guess right here we're going to do kind of an intersection because what we're going to be doing is heading off this way and the road is going to extend all the way over to this plains biome right here. And this is the start of the gaming district, is right over here. Cookie asked me to go ahead and set this up or at least get a portal over here. So I've set up a temporary one at the top of this hill. But we're going to be setting up a entrance building over here, kind of at this, almost this little, I don't want to say peninsula, but it's basically like a little offshoot of the biome. We're going to set up an entrance building over here eventually, and that is what the road will dead into, somewhere right around here, which I'm pretty excited about. And of course, there will be another portal over here. I'll move that one that's over there to over here eventually, once we get this road in place. But like I said, I got to gather a lot of deep slate. Now, for over here at the actual building, oh man, we're actually starting to have this thing weather a bit. You can see here, almost all of that bright orange is gone. We're down to this sort of dull, almost brownish color that we've got now. So we're getting there. We're getting there as far as the roof goes. Oxidization. I can't speak today. I'm sorry. But what we're going to be doing today is heading into the Nether because we have to get that portal set up. I actually need to have grabbed the coordinates from over there. Okay, I got the coordinates, so we can head into the Nether now. Now, I want to do this with you guys because I want to try out, we should have dynamic portals or something along those lines installed. I forget exactly what the name of it is. We're going to go to 170, so quite a bit of ways this way. And then we have to go to, I believe, 17, if I'm not mistaken. Yes. 170, 18. So we should have dynamic portals installed, or whatever it's called. So that means that we can build different sized portals. And I totally forgot this was a thing that we could do. Okay, so we should be able to go about right here. Which is great, because this isn't too far from everyone as far as the Nether roof goes. I think this is kind of off. I think the end portal is, like, right there. If you head that way. So let's try to build like a wacky portal size here. I mean, I don't have enough blocks for this. Let's go, I don't know, I want to do something super weird just so we can test out how this works. I may need to get the corners off of this so that we can have an extra few blocks. I don't know if this will work. I don't really understand how this data pack works. I don't know if you have to do something special to get it to actually function, but I just want to see if putting these in the expected locations will do the job. I got a flap on top of this. Let's see. If you can't tell, today's another chill episode sort of day. I've been working on a lot of stuff outside of the server, so I haven't had as much time to really record stuff. Okay, that's fine. I don't like that that's like that, so we're actually going to take this piece and we're going to connect that a little bit. This isn't the size we're going to keep, even if this works, but I just want to see if this works. No. I don't understand how these work. Oh! Oh! Okay, that did work. Weird. That looks so weird. Oh, that's so uncomfortable. I love it. I love that so much. Okay, we'll do some sort of really wacky portal over here now that we know that that actually works. So, oh, this is cool. We can do something maybe lore-wise with this about why it's this shape. And of course, it'll probably be closer to about here when we get the entrance building made. But I just want to make sure that this connects up with what we're doing. I think next episode we'll work on the road and the entrance building because I'm actually pretty excited about it. I've got a fun idea. Yeah, that worked perfectly. Let me make sure it connects back up to this. Here. Yes! Okay, perfect. That worked great. So, we're actually going to take a trip into Minecraft Bedrock Edition because I want to show you guys an entrance that I made to a gaming district on a friend server that I never really did anything with. I never really finished it. And I think I want to build a slightly smaller scale version of that here. So, we're going to go check that out real quick. All right, we should be coming up on my nether base here. I have, oops, there's some carts on the track. I have lots of bases set up on this world, and for some reason, this block is missing, but that's fine. I have lots of bases set up all over this world. This is a world that I play in with a few friends of mine, and this is my nether base. This thing is, well, it's large and it's very cool. But we're not here for this base, and we're not here for what's on the other side of that portal either. We're gonna head upstairs and go into the end because that is where our gaming district that we haven't really done anything with yet is set up. Now, I've got about 50 videos or so of this world on the channel, so if you're interested in any of that, a lot of that stuff is on here. I don't think I've done everything on camera, but there are a lot of fun things. But let's head into the end and check this out. We also have a resource pack on this world, so everything looks a little bit different than it normally would. But let's head over here because we have this awesome ice road, and yes, there are some boats. I was hoping for this. We have this awesome ice road set up that heads off towards my end base that I was working on. So let's head out here. This thing is super fast. You can see I fought like 24 dragons to get all the portals in place, and Bedrock Edition is weird, so some of the arrows and stuff are still flying around. But I want to show you guys this journey in because when the base loads in, I think your minds are going to be just a little bit blown by how large this base is. Here we go. Should load in any moment. Now I'm going to slow down a little bit. Yes! Yes! Oh, this thing is so cool. Okay, I'm going to stop there because I want to take a look at this thing. This thing is so cool. I haven't been here in quite a while. So basically what this is, and I'm going to take a screenshot of this because this is going to be today's thumbnail. I think I have to do it like that. This is a Lego set, actually, if you're not familiar. Oh, the beacons didn't load in quite yet. This is a Lego set. It's a Jokerland Lego set that was part of the Lego Batman movie, I believe. And as you can see, not nearly finished. And we've got the house, or part of the house from Lock and Key over there as well, that I was working on. But this thing is super cool. And I'm very, very happy with it. Now, I don't want to go nearly this scale because this is absolutely absurd, but I do really love this build. So I think maybe half or a quarter of this scale would be pretty cool. So for kind of a frame of reference, instead of doing the windows as, what is this, 4 by 8? Maybe we could do like 2 by 3. So you could scale it down to about that size and then do the whole building at that scale. You're gonna lose a lot of detail. But I think it'll look pretty cool for the gaming district because it doesn't need to be huge. And then of course we can replace this road that leads up here with our massive road that we're doing. It would be really cool to build this thing full scale, but I don't really think we need to do that. I think that would be a little bit insane. The more I look at it, the more I want to do it, but we're not going to do that. That's too much. It's too much. I have to stop myself from continuing. But yeah, so this is one of my favorite things that I've built in Minecraft, I think by far. Just the ability to, I love how well I was able to recreate the Lego set. It looks pretty much just like the Lego set, if you know what it looks like. But yeah, I'm pretty happy with this thing. If you guys would like to see me play in this world more, let me know. My Bedrock Edition videos do pretty well, but it's hard to keep two Minecraft series going at once. So if you guys would like to see this, let me know. But this is kind of my plans. I know today was a very talky episode, but I want to get this out to you guys today. So I think that is going to do it for this one. But if you did enjoy it, be sure to leave a like and subscribe for more content and let me know what you guys would like to see. And I will see all of you in the next episode. Man, I really want to finish that build as well. Maybe someday.